My name is Kate Gockenheimer, and I'm a stained glass artist.
I've always been attracted to things that look like they took a long time. Detail and hard work, and I think that's sort of like the thread that goes through the things that I've made. In terms of the inspiration for the stained glass that I've made in the last couple of years, it's really been from textiles and fabric. Super beautiful, like, patterns that you can get in fabric that's harder to do in glass for sure. Mostly like Japanese textiles and kimonos and stuff. So I studied architecture and art history. And then I went to the North Bennett Street School, which is a trade school in Boston in the North End. It just so happened a stained glass studio in Boston was looking for somebody. So it just really worked out, and I still work part-time for him, you know, almost 20 years later. I usually just start by doing a little sketch of my idea. The next step is to do a scale drawing. So I'll do something, you know, that fits on a regular sheet of paper. Figuring out what colors I'm going to use, drawing little versions of the designs that I need to sandblast. Then I'll do a full-size drawing on vellum. Then I have to cut all my glass, grind it all, just so that I don't get cut by the edges. Peel part of the pattern away so that whatever's uncovered will get sandblasted off. Each piece of glass potentially has been fired 3 times. Then it all needs to be glazed together. It's like putting a puzzle together. There's something really satisfying about seeing it all come together, you know? So that's definitely my favorite part. This is, you know, 1,000-year-old process of stained glass glazing. There's nothing new and fancy about the way I put them together. I was purposely trying to make a few windows that were a little simpler, that weren't quite as sandblasted and decorated and layered as I usually do it. Which is not easy for me to do. It's an exercise in restraint. I don't know. I think that I've always been attracted to ornateness and sort of decoration and detail, and like when I used to make little clay busts, little portraits of people, you know, there was a lot of steps and a lot of detail and a lot of small ornateness to them. And the paper sculptures that I made, it was kind of the same thing. A lot of labor in actually making each little round paper tuft, you know, that part took longer than, you know, putting them together into a sculptural form. There are ways to make my job slightly easier, but I kind of like doing things by hand and having things be not totally perfect. I don't know, I always just really liked glass.